Hello guys, mkoaji. I trust kila mtu wako poa. Pia mimi niko poa. This is Ernest Masharia, your accountant. And I want to take this opportunity to welcome each and everybody in today's session. Na kama ndio mara yako ya kwanza unajiunga nasi, karibu sana. And remember to subscribe to this channel ili tukikuwa na kitu mpya unakuwa mtu wa kwanza kupata the notification. Siku ya leo I have a very very interesting topic for you, and that is to do with the taxation. This is a very wide topic. Najua tutaiangalia kwa muda, so I will first introduce what I have for you, and from there we shall have several sessions with you, and this is to do with the taxation. Tutaangalia types za taxes obligations. Kama wewe ni mtu wa VAT, kama wewe ni mtu wa income tax, kama wewe ni mtu wa excise duty, kama wewe ni mtu wa turnover taxes, kama wewe ni mtu wa PAYE, this wide topic is for you. So invite your friend, invite your colleague, let's move together in this very educative program. So today I have a topic to do with withholding taxes. I know a lot of people have been appointed by KRA or the Commission of Domestic Taxes as a withholding agent, and that's what I want us to look today, to understand what does withholding taxes entail. So have a notebook, have a pen. Our topic today is on withholding taxes. And what is this withholding taxes that we are talking about? Withholding taxes is a type of tax deducted from a certain income. So you are there, you are a consultant, umefanya kazi pale, there is a certain percentage of your amount that must be withheld to be remitted to the Commission of the Domestic Taxes. So it is a tax withheld at source. It is withheld at source, and a person making a certain payment deducts tax at the applicable rates and remits the tax to the Commissioner of Domestic Taxes on behalf of the recipient. So kama wewe ndiye ulikuwa umenipatia kazi, nimefanya kazi, nimemaliza, nimekupatia invoice, you will remit a certain percentage of the amount to be paid to me to the Commissioner of Domestic Taxes. So I have several categories of withholding taxes, and we shall start with the withholding taxes on income tax. Withholding taxes on income tax. And under this, who is eligible? Who is eligible for this withholding tax on income tax? All the services that are subject to the withholding taxes, which are stipulated under the Act of Withholding Tax, are subjected to withholding tax. So what do I mean? There is that Withholding Tax Act that explains which are these services that are subjected to withholding taxes. So you must be appointed as a withholding agent by the Commission of Domestic Taxes for you to be able to withhold that certain percentage and remit it to the KRA. So we must have two parties, that is the withholdee and the withholder. So the withholder is the person who is making the payment to the KRA on behalf of the withholdee. So the withholder ni yule mtu umefanyia kazi. Ukimpatia ile invoice, atakata ile tax, ataremit to the KRA on behalf of you. So is this withholding tax final? Is it a final tax? So withholding taxes depends on nature of the transaction. It can be final or an advance payment. So there are those withholding taxes that are final, and others, they are advanced taxes. So unaripa kidogo, and then the withholdee will pay the remaining percentage of the tax. So when it is made as an advance payment, it is used to offset the receipt tax liability to the government. So kama nilikuwa nilipe a certain percentage, withholder na nilipia a certain percentage, then mimi nitaripa the difference. In case of the withholding tax being final, which are these cases where withholding tax is deemed to be final? One, winnings, those people that are gamblers, betting companies, they withhold a certain amount of money after you win a certain bet and then remit that amount to the Commission of Domestic Taxes. That tax is final. Two, qualifying dividends. Three, qualifying interests from banks, buildings, etc. And number four is pension. So pension also, ukikatwa ile withholding tax, that tax is final. So under this income tax withholding, there are certain or common rates for common services. And one of them is management fee. And remember, any withholding tax, be it for VAT, be it for income tax, be it for rental, it varies from 2% to 25%. Hakuna withholding tax yenye iko above 25% na iko below 2%. So management fee rate, if you are resident in Kenya, it's 5%. For non-resident, is 20%. Professional fees, the rate is 5% for resident, and for non-resident, it's 20%. winnings 20% for both, royalties 5% for resident and 20% for non-resident, dividends 5% for resident and 10% for non-resident, interests for banks, that is 15% for both resident and non-resident, interests for housing, it's 10% for resident, 15% for non-resident, interest on government bonds, those people who invested on bonds, for resident and non-resident, it's 15%. Consultancy, those people who are offering consultancy services, for resident, it's 5%, and for non-resident, it's 20%. So that is on withholding taxes, on income taxes. Now, let us look on value-added tax, withholding taxes on value-added tax. So under this, the rate is 2% of the VAT, of the 16% VAT, or 2% of the taxable amount. 2. It is remitted within 5 working days. So, and under this, you cannot withhold taxes for zero rated or exempted surprise. You just withhold VATable surprise. And category number 3 of withholding taxes is rental income tax. Rental income tax. And under this, since the Finance Act 2023, the rate changed from 10% to 7.5% on the taxable amount. And also, it is paid on 5 working days. So, ukiremit, make sure it's within 5 working days. Does withholding tax apply to employees? No. Any employee is subjected to pay PSU1 taxes, so the salaries are not subjected to withholding taxes. So usifanye mistake una withhold salary ya mfanyakazi yoyote. For salaries, you will charge PSU1. So who are exempted for these withholding taxes? That is one on income taxes. On income taxes. Payments made to tax exempt bodies. Payments made to tax exempt bodies. 2. Local management and professional fees whose aggregate is below 24,000 per month. 3. Air travel commissions paid by local air operators to overseas agents. And 4. Marketing commissions and residue audit fees paid to foreign agents in respect of export of flowers, fruits, and vegetables. Exempt for VAT withholding. Non-VAT are withheld. Sorry, no VAT is withheld on exempt goods and services. And zero-rated surprise. So, any VAT withheld in exempt and zero-rated surprise is treated as tax paid in error and therefore refundable by the commissioner. I've said, if you've withheld taxes for zero rated or exempted surprise, na umeripa hiyo tax, this tax is refundable, so you can claim back and get refunded. When should it be paid and submitted? So nimesema for VAT or for both is 5 working days from July 2023. That is when the Finance Act 2023 took effect. And a taxpayer whose VAT has been withheld is still required to submit an online VAT return and account for the VAT balance. So it is not a final tax. For withholding, for VAT withholding, it's not a final tax. So kama wewe ni a withholding agent, make sure you know the rates of what you are withholding, and also remember, if you don't pay these withholding taxes on time, there are accrue penalties and interest. So they have that deadline, we've said, VAT and for income taxes, remitted on 5 working days. So before ziishe 5 working days, make sure umelipa the withholding taxes. Failure to which, it will attract penalties and interest. So when we meet next time, tutaangalia value added tax. What does it entail? I know a lot of people are under this obligation, na ni vizuri pia tusaidiane kuelimishana kidogo, tujue what is required of us. So until then, thank you very much for giving me your time. Remember to subscribe, remember to share, remember to watch my content, remember to support the channel. Thank you very much. Have a nice time. Thank you.